about arm weight and without basically any other prelude. I just want to show you how it feels to play without arm weight and with arm weight. I mean, people call it arm weight, but for me it's basically the weight, the freedom of your whole body that helps you to play. Alright, so this one I would play without arm weight. Okay, so just playing. Okay, I need to hold it because I used to play with it.
Okay, let's make it step by step. First, let's sing with glissando.
like a choir conductor. Hey, let's go. So now the resistance, what is this? Basically, I explained already before, when you move your hand in the air, there's no resistance. When you move your hand in the water, there is resistance, even though you tend to make the same, but then it will be like resistance in the water. So it's not like very harsh, but it's soft, but still resistance. Why do we need it? To be able to control our fingers while playing and express and convey everything we want, and not like we play and after that we realize the sound didn't sound or it was too harsh, so we have no control over what we're doing. We need to prepare our finger, okay? And the way our muscles react is the way we sing. So when we feel this resistance, this resistance sensation here activate muscles here. So when we will sing internally, while going through this feeling this resistance, the muscles here will respond right away. So basically I'm just explaining why we need to do this resistance. To be able to control, to play with relaxed hands, and it works even in fast tempos. Even when I play in fast tempos. So, Manda, I'm gonna sing and then you repeat. Because sometimes you have gaps between you.
Yeah.
And
I'm sorry.
No, that's okay, we're gonna sing once you again. So now, when you sing out loud, remember the sensations, and basically you're gonna sing first time out loud, and then internally. So this is how I sing internally. The sensations here will be sustained, but you just don't lose any voice. Okay, so you intonate and you feel how you reach the next note. Okay, so next time. Do you feel right? Some movement? Okay, and now backwards.
Okay, so.
the same thing internally. You feel something, right? And now when you go down, so this the thing when you sing internally, this is how you're gonna sing every single gap between notes while playing. So we're gonna go to the part where we're gonna try to play together with singing, and you can just come here and see. So the first thing I just want to mention, we're gonna play just into notes. So whatever we want to convey, any ideas in our head, we need to kind of align our movements. Otherwise, if we sing to the right but there is no movement to the right, the energy, like the movement that here, we couldn't express our ideas. So if we're gonna sing to the right, we're gonna move wrist to the right. So basically, bring your absolutely loose, empty hand and just bring, move your wrist. Okay? Now, next thing I'll ask you to do is play and sing together. And the last thing, you're gonna play and sing internally. And you're gonna play the next note only after you reach it with your voice. Okay? Who's first? Yeah, okay. This is not the end. Again, just start with movement first. You wanna close. you know, you can you make just this move? You know, you can make actually this move. Yeah. Just like this. Up, right, left, right, left. Yay, okay. Our body is able to do this. That these movements that you do right now, when you play fast, they become very small. Like when you look how I play fast, you cannot even say I move my wrist, but I do move my wrist because these movements are just in the memories of my muscles. And we need to do this because if we don't do this, then our wrist will become stiff, especially when we play fast. So this is for our wrist be flexible and alive, so it wouldn't be dead when we have that tension. And the beauty of this exercise that when you especially go down, this is how you start develop your thumb because it will become independent. Because when we usually play with four notes, this is like a tail somewhere to help us to move to another position. But when you start developing muscles here, feel, and eventually you will develop a nice thumb. This is the first part, and like I said, everything you play, you always intonate this way. And I bet you never did this because all you did is just press the note at the right time, love the song. Okay, so like I said, the beauty of this is that you can also, even if you play very fast, you're still able to intonate. So this one's just a slow movement. So the next part, the second part of our workshop, now how to feel this free energy and how to connect to your singing and express.